You can't get out of this neighborhood, you cut it up. You cut it up with the world. And you let them know, yes, I can. And he wants to get you a master swordsman. So when the enemy comes against you, everything he tries to bring against you is contrary to his word. That's why the Lord says, bring every thought under the obedience of Christ. How are you doing that? Everything that comes against me and tries to tell me different than God, I bring up the sword and I cut it up. And the thing is this, oh, thank you, Holy Ghost. The thing is this, if it was so bad, it wouldn't be able to be cut up by the sword. If what you're trying to tell me was so true, then the word wouldn't be able to cut it up. It would break off of it. If it was more powerful than the word. If your sword is stronger than my sword, and I'm fighting you in the sword, your sword would break my sword. But God's sword has never been broken. Never been broken. Every time I wield it, something happens.
Yeah.
Every time I wield it, he brings things about. Every time I wield it,
go ahead.
It happens. I was going to work yesterday morning about the clothes. I'm going to show you the power of the word. Going to work yesterday morning, I'm thinking about the storm. And I begin to pray. I said, Lord, now I need you down under to protect my house. But I need you to protect every partner of LLWC. And I plead the blood.
Yes.
Say, Lord, I don't need no power to go out there. When the power went out, I went looking at God. Hold up, Lord. I just prayed this. About 12 o'clock, the power came back. In a hurricane, power don't come out. Let me take a couple days before you get power. But when you got God on your side, and the enemy think he's going to take you out, all you got to do is wield the sword. And I plead the blood over every partner of LLWC. I got no text about somebody losing property. I got no text about praying for us, pastor, because we lost this and this fell and this, this fell and that. Why? Because the prayer of the righteous availeth much. We find out that in the word of God, that one man prayed and it didn't rain for 3 years, and then he prayed again and then it did rain. If he can do that and he finally the same qualification that he did, I can pray for every partner and every partner's home, every partner's property will be protected by the blood of Jesus. Trees on top of cars and things falling apart. Now I walk around my house and all I see is one tree. They hit a grill that was already broke, so that won't make no difference. Ain't hit no new grill, hit the grill that was already broke. Hit a fence that was already down. I'm trying to get my brother-in-law to come there and fix that up for me, but it hit a fence that was already down. Because God honors his word. And even in the midst of a storm, I can wield the sword of God. And the sword of chocolate. Protected every partner. Protected all of us. Here I come down, my soul, power should be out. Come to the church and just to check on it. Power is on.
Yeah.
Why? He knew those two little girls wanted to sing.
Amen.
He didn't want to let them down. Yeah. You see the kind of vibe we serve. He knew their parents were looking forward to seeing them sing. Didn't want to let them die. I'll let power be in the church. There won't be no power anywhere else.
Look at God.
Just to show them who I am.
Yes.
Because think about how God, he loves showing off.
Yes, he does. Yes, he does.
Just so you know. I wish I had Brother Mac here. I wish I had Brother Mac. Deacon Mac is my dancing deacon at the former church I went to. But Deacon Mac I talked to Deacon Mac, and he'd tell me, brother, you know, I got high off everything. You name it, I took it. And he said, the reason I got saved was because when I went to the altar, God gave me a high that I never experienced before.
Uh-huh.
And I didn't have to take no drugs to do it.
Yes.
See, I wish I can't use that testimony for my testimony, because that's not my testimony. But he can tell you everything he took, how to take it, how to smoke it, how to do it. And he said, when God got him at that altar and touched him and gave him that high, he didn't want to go back and get nothing else. He wanted to come back to church and get that high again.
Yeah.
Yeah. keep on proving himself.
Yes.
Why do I still do what I do? Well, sometimes you don't feel like doing it. Because he keeps on proving himself to me. And keeps showing me how good he is. That's why I can stand. Because what you say doesn't change how good he's been to me.
That's right.
All that you're trying to do doesn't change how good he's been to me. And it is a personal relationship.
Yes.
And if you put on the whole armor, the shield, the shoes, the belt, the breastplate, the helmet, so, if you put the whole armor on, then when the enemy comes and tries to take you out, you are ready for him. Mm-hmm. And you'll find out one thing about the devil. He don't really want to be in a real fight.
Amen. Amen.
He don't want to really be in a real fight.
Amen.
And so I got to the point, instead of being scared of the devil, I get to the point, you don't want to come by my house today. So I'm not in the right mood. I can pray too long, fasted too long. You come in here, it's going to be on.
And that's the way it should be in your house.
Why does he have to come in and do everything he wants to do? He don't. You can put things in order by putting on the whole armor and beginning to declare things out of your mouth. Already in the world. Would you rest to your feet all over the world?